Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife unboxing, and today we're looking at another interesting custom knife. This is a bit an older one from 2018 that I got actually on the secondary market, and I just wanted to show it off because it's now a part of the collection, and it also has some very special features from a maker that I think his work is kind of underappreciated. I had a knife from the same maker before. There's also an older video on my channel. I will link that in the description as well as in the top right corner, so you can check that out. But now let's get into the unboxing on this knife that I got in a very good trade, in my opinion, from the secondary market. It came just in this kind of non-branded nice pouch. And let's open it up right here. So that's the knife itself. I don't know if any of you kind of recognize the maker just from how this knife looks. So we have a very interesting kind of scale material. This is also something I never had before, this type of material. And I will talk about that later on as well. And then we got a very interestingly anodized orange peeled titanium frame lock side, and there you can see the logo of the maker, which is Jesse Jarros, which is an American knife maker that does a lot of different models, handmade custom knives, and this is one of his, I think, lesser known models because it's a flipper. Most of his very well-known knives are thumb stud opening or hole opening knives, for example the M75, which was the one I had before. And he has some other kind of knives that have multiple opening mechanisms. And this is his Flare model. So this is a Jesse Jarros Flare from 2018 that he actually made for the 10th iteration of the Gathering in the US, which is a knife show, a custom knife show. I found that out after I actually did the trade. I contacted Mr. Jarros and he was very kind of letting me know the story behind the knife and what the materials were and everything, because the guy that I traded it from didn't have a lot of information, which is certainly not his fault. It's also not his knife that he purchased from the maker, so that's just things you have to deal with in the kind of secondary market. I will just show you this here in 4K. Very interesting kind of anodizing here with those kind of burnt areas. And then you see that the backspacer is from the same material than we have on the scale. And this is actually carbo quartz. I heard of that. I also saw it on some really, really very expensive custom knives back in the day. And now I think it's not that well used. I haven't seen a lot of knives that actually still use carbo quartz. But this is a combination, as far as I have understood, is like a layered process where you have a quartz sand and carbon fiber kind of layered very thinly. And then you get this very interesting looking material that still is actually quite strong. And I think at this time there are also different kind of colors available when you color the kind of sand part of this composite material. So that's quite interesting here. Another interesting fact about this Jesse Jarros Flare is the blade. Because usually his flares have a spear point blade, so this kind of cutout here in the blade is actually very unique, and Mr. Jarros told me that he thinks that this is actually probably the only one that has this special blade shape. So this is actually a one-off flare that I got here in trade. Blade steels on all the flares is ABL steel, so certainly not a super high-end powder metallurgy steel, but in custom knives that's a very well-known steel, very well appreciated steel, a bit like RWL 34. So certainly a good steel for a knife of this kind of handmade character. We also see we have a gorgeous hand drop satin. There are some signs of use. I don't know if I can pick it up in the camera, but there are some finer scratches, actually a couple of them around here and also in the tip area, but that was disclosed to me, so no hard feelings. I knew that going in, and this is certainly more of a user knife for me, and also a very cool piece to actually have in the collection because I really like Jesse Jarros' work. It's a very kind of function-driven design. He also does some very good-looking kitchen knives and just fixed blades. And this is also a bit of a blast from the past in the way it is made. So we have a standard kind of orange-peeled and contoured titanium scale with this interesting anodizing. No lock bar insert, no over-travel stop. And we also have a knife or a flipper, which is even more interesting, running on washers. As far as I have been able to gather, these are nylon washers that this knife runs on, and it still flips really well. You just certainly notice it when you close it. You have more of a more resistance there. It's not free falling like you have it with ball bearings, but it actually doesn't feel gritty or anything. It's just a different kind of, more kind of hydraulic feel. And now I certainly will kind of lube it up, but it still feels very, very nice, very defined, very solid. And that is certainly an adjective that I would use with all of the Jesse Jaros' knives that I have seen and handled. Solid made knives, knives that are made for actual work and just look good. And his prices are actually also quite reasonable, and the deal I got on this one is also very, very nice, so I really couldn't pass that up. And you also see hand cut jimping here on the spine, really good looking. Is a bit larger in the beginning and also more angled, and then kind of tightens up towards the divot there. And also I think in actual use this divot is actually quite useful. But we will see that when I actually had time to carry and use it. We have standard kind of Torx construction. Flow through almost everything, just the little kind of backspacer here with the lanyard hole made from carbo quartz. Also not very heavy. This is actually a very easy knife to carry, I would think, because the overall footprint in this dimension is nice and slim. And it's also quite slim in this dimension. You just have the flipper tab, which actually has all the jimping on the top, so not the front. So it's more of a kind of push button flipper. So you also can overcome the bit more friction you have because of running on washers. Now let's show it against some other knives we have here in the collection to give you a bit of a feel for the size of the flare here. It also come nice and sharp from the guy I traded it with, so very, very good trade overall, very, very open in terms of communication and letting me know everything about the knife that he knew. So let's take a look at the flare compared to some other knives that I have here assorted for you. So here we have the Simon Stricker's Tour, which is probably the knife that I felt is the kind of closest in overall form factor. And you see it's pretty much identical. The two runs on bearings, and you certainly feel that in the manipulation. But it's also a bit of a tighter flipper. I certainly can shake it closed easily, and this is also a full titanium handled one, so it's certainly heavier. But certainly an overall kind of feel in the hand and overall size very close to the Jaros flare. Then I have the JK Knives Integra, also a custom. This is a Polish custom knife, 3D mil titanium clip, also running on bearings. This is certainly a very different action than on the flare. As you can see here, it's also a little bit larger than the flare. And then we have a very well-known knife, just to give you some perspective. This is, of course, a Protec Malibu. Great knife, certainly lots of content on the Malibu out there, and you see that it is slightly larger in the handle as well as in the blade against this Protec Malibu. In the hand, it actually feels quite nice. You can feel like the last kind of corner here on this backspacer. These are just first impressions and an unboxing, so I can't really tell if that's going to bother me or not, but I would think not really. We have the standard kind of bent Jesse Jaros clip. I don't know if he does any other clips on his knives. I haven't seen any kind of 3D milled clips or anything, but I would imagine that this works actually quite well. But you will have about this much sticking up. And on this knife, not only on this knife, I think on all the Jesse Jaros knives, I think this clip really just fits very well, because he really makes toolish looking and feeling knives. Solid toolish knives that are very well made. His grinds are really, really impressive. Also here in this almost full flat grind, and the very nicely done hand drop set and finish here. Interesting blade shape, good plunge grind, good sharpening chug. You even can do a bit of a foregrip here with my sized fingers, so I was really glad to see that. I can also do the thumb here in the front, so I think I will have lots of fun carrying and using this flare. Also, access on the liner is very nicely done. Good cutout, nice chamfer. And the detent is actually very well tuned for a knife with washers or a flipper with washers as its pivot system. So really good looking thing. I love to have something with carbo quartz in the collection. And thanks again to the guy from Instagram, he knows who he is, for actually making this trade possible. And I hope he's happy with what he got in trade as well. So very cool knife here, the Jesse Jaros Flare. Stay tuned on the channel and on Instagram for more content on this knife. There will be a full review later on, and you will certainly see some EDC loadout pictures and some other content on Instagram on this gorgeous piece by Jesse Jaros for sure. So don't forget to follow me there at 7ready_knife_reviews and follow me here for more content as well. And check out Jesse Jaros's Instagram also. Thanks again for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.